Senator Rob Portman joins me now from Capitol Hill. He serves on the Finance Committee and is a former director of the Office of Management and Budget under President George W. Bush. You're kind of a number cruncher by nature. What do you think of this economy that we're in right now, and how much of the credit goes to this president?
John, it's really exciting because it's what all of us have been hoping for, not just the increase in the stock market, which helps a lot of 401k plans out there, not just the increase in economic growth. We now have projections of next year to be going over 2.5%, and not just the jobs, and the job numbers have been good. But for me, the most exciting news is we're seeing wages begin to go up. And this is something we really haven't seen in a couple of decades. If you look at it from an inflation-adjusted basis, wages have been flat, whereas expenses, particularly health care, have gone up dramatically. So this is exactly what some of us were hoping for, is that the combination of reforming burdensome regulations and, very significantly, fixing a broken tax system that actually encouraged jobs and investment going overseas is beginning to make a big difference for workers in Ohio and across the country. And so that's exciting to me.
Our chief White House correspondent, John Roberts, has had some inklings of what is coming tonight. He tells us to expect a bright and optimistic speech. He also says the president is going to slip in some things that people do not expect. I suppose you're one of those who might be surprised, but any idea what the president might be hinting at there?
Well, I think talking about the economy is important, but the next step in the economy, in my view, which I hope you will talk about, I know he cares about and his team cares about, is workforce. Because right now we're seeing across the country many employers who are ready to hire, ready to add more people. Encouraging more investment through this tax cut is one thing, but you got to have the workforce to be able to have the expansion we all want. So I hope we'll talk some about that, being sure workers have the skills needed for 21st century jobs, whether it's in healthcare, whether it's in IT, whether it's in manufacturing. We have big gaps in all those areas. And then second, the opioid crisis. I know, again, he's got a passion for this, but we need to figure out much more constructive ways to deal with this issue. In my own state of Ohio, we had overdoses and deaths increase again last year from the previous year. Unfortunately, we're not seeing this getting better around the country, rather getting worse. And this has an impact on everything. Families being broken apart, communities devastated, increase in crime, and an impact on the economy. There are many employers who are having a tough time getting people to pass drug tests. And part of this is because of this opioid epidemic that has gripped our country. So I hope we'll talk about that as well.
That new Senate report on the amount of illegal opioids that has been seized in international mail deliveries to the U.S. Raised a lot of eyebrows. The Postal Service unknowingly smuggling drugs. What are we supposed to do about that, Senator?
Well, John, you're absolutely right. We studied it for a year. The subcommittee that I chair had a hearing on this, and we did a report last week that was shocking because it showed that this fentanyl and carfentanil, these are the synthetic opioids, so sort of a synthetic form of heroin, are being produced in China primarily and then shipped through our own U.S. mail system right into our communities. So we've got to stop this poison from coming into our communities. We know what the post office could do better in order to provide law enforcement the information they need to be able to identify and stop these packages. And our legislation called the STOP Act is something the president's commission supported. We got to get that done. That's one of the things that can be done and should be done right away to begin to keep some of this deadly drug out of our communities.
Is anyone at the post office fighting that idea?
Well, I met with the Postmaster General yesterday on that topic. Yes, they're concerned about us putting this in place because they say they don't have the resources, they need more time and so on. But this is an urgent matter. Back in 2002, Congress directed the post office to study this issue, gave them the authorization to do it. We required all the private carriers to do it, so the FedExes and UPSs and DHLs have to do it. All we're saying is give law enforcement the information they need about these packages, where they're from, what's in it, where it's going. Then they can identify these packages. Law enforcement wants it. Communities back home in Ohio want it. We need to get it done.
Senator Rob Portman, Republican of Ohio, we wish you well in that pursuit. Thank you, sir.
Thanks, John. Appreciate you.